that's important to let the horse approach you. Hi. I don't have anything to eat. Hi. I'm just going to walk away for a minute. Huh? Okay, he's going to act kind of... horses around and around town. You introduce yourself, you give them time to... When they start to use a clicker too, you start with the clicker for the phobic horse, and then you can use a tongue click, or you can use a good, something that you wouldn't normally say. Hindgut disengagement is something that a lot of people use to help a horse get out of your space and to respect them. But if you go up and poke a horse in the butt, it's like somebody coming up and shoving you in the shoulder and saying, spin around. You take it personally and get defensive. Instead, learn to expand your space with your energy that we were talking about. So I'm going to concentrate. I know he's going to turn on me. I'm going to concentrate on making my personal space bigger. So he's going to come around with that inside hoof and come around and come out of my space. And it's only because I'm looking at my space, Bella, and expanding it. Good. Okay. Didn't have to ask him anything. And you said right hand, right. Oh, you said he was phobic on the right side. In what manner?
Just even going over there.
Oh.
Although he just let you.
No, you cannot bite. No teeth. No teeth. Back, please. Back. Out. Back. You are a handsome boy, but I want you. I don't want your teeth. Did you hear the tongue click?
Yes.
Blinking horse is a thinking horse. Back. My space.
Good boy.
No? No? Thank you. one thing, if he starts to muck face, teach him to face. Okay? I just held out my finger. Can you leave my finger on my hand, please? Face. And when he moves his head back, forward. Okay, at the same, you're using the word face. Good. Okay, and you mark it. Face. See how quick he picked up on that? You're right, he's very smart, he's very sensitive. Now let's see if he figures it out. Good. Okay, so he didn't have to come into contact with my finger. Do you have your clicker on yet? Do you mind if I open it?
No, go ahead.
Break it in? Because I want him to get to know the noise, too. Some horses get scared by the noise at first. Back. 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 That foot. Good. Good, mister. I don't like anybody on my right side. Good. You have to come up and get it if you want it. No. Up here. Oh, good boy. No mugging face. You need to teach face on both sides. Face. And for a horse that likes to get in your space and get all over you, you want the face. Face. Figure it out. You can figure it out. Face. No, don't eat my jacket. Figure it out. Good. That was kind of half. His face got in the way of his feet. Or his feet got in the way of the face. Figure it out. Up. Face. No. Face. No, it doesn't scare you, does it? Don't eat my jacket, my sweet. Face. So when you're thinking you don't want him to mug you for the treats, you said he gets to be a treat hound, what's the opposite behavior? What would you like him to do instead?
Wait patiently until it's offered.
Waiting is awesome, and every horse should learn how to wait. But if you can't wait for right now, instead of going like this, getting after me, you want to teach him to do the opposite, turn his head away, right? Got it. No, I don't want you to go forward, I want you to come around. Right, no, this feet. Good. See what I did there? My hand was up to prevent him from walking into me as a barrier. I just went, good. All I had to do was look at his hind feet. Okay, let's see if he can do head down. Does he know head down?
Yes.
What is your cue for head down?
Head down.
Head down. Head down. Head down. Head down. No. Head down. All the way down. All the way down. Head down. Good. Now we talked about negative reinforcement, positive head down. reinforcement versus positive reinforcement. He'll start to choose to put his head down. We're actually shaping a behavior, but we're not waiting for it to happen, like we talked about waiting for something to happen. Now I'm waiting for it to happen. Uh-uh. We're going to ignore the behavior we don't want as long as it's safe. Figure it out. Because what we're trying to do is get him to use his cognizant. His cognizant mind to figure things out, to problem solve. Right now. No, if you want it, head down. Head down. Head down. Head down. No, head down. All right, first face. Face. Good, head down. Now we can change. Two behaviors into one, face and then head down. Let's see if we can get them to chain. I'm taking two behaviors and chaining them together to make a bigger behavior. Face, head down. Face, head down. Face, you see him blinking? He's starting to process all this. Head down. See the different look in his eye and when we started?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he's trying to figure all this out. Good. Good. Horses know the intent. People too. Face.
Pick it up. Pick it up.
Thank you. You're not sure about his hind end. Can you hand me that?